Okay, children, till now we discussed about the lifestyle of Jammu and Kashmir and also about the Himachal Pradesh. Now, we will discuss about Uttarakhand. So, children, looking to page number 17 in your textbook here, we can see about Uttarakhand. So, Dehradun is the capital of Uttarakhand. What is the capital city of Uttarakhand, children? Dehradun. So, Dehradun is the capital of Uttarakhand. Tharkar and Kumaon Hill ranges come under Uttarakhand. There are two hill stations which come under Uttarakhand. What are the two hill stations, children? They are Gharwal and Kumaon. These are the two hill stations which come under Uttarakhand. The important hill stations of this region are, so there are some important hill stations which are present in Uttarakhand. What are they? They are Mussoorie, Nainital and Rani Cave. What they are, children? Mussoorie, Nainital and Rani Cave. These are the three important hill stations which are present in Uttarakhand. The popular religious places in Uttarakhand means the tourist places, the famous places which are represented in Uttarakhand are Haridwar, Kedarnath, Badrinath, Gangotri and Yamunotri. So these are the five famous places which are present in Uttarakhand. What are the children? They are Haridwar, Kedarnath, Badrinath, Gangotri and Yamunotri. Next, we will learn about Sikkim and West Bengal. Sikkim is a small and beautiful state. The capital of South Sikkim is Gangtok. The three main tribes found here are Lepcha, Bhutia and Nepali. So, children, Sikkim is a very small and beautiful state. And what is the capital of Sikkim, children? It is Gangtok. So, here you can see three types of tribal people. What tribal people, children? The people who live in forest. They are little short in the high culture. So, there are three main tribes people found in this Sikkim place. What are that? See, they are Lepcha, Bhutia and Nepali. These three tribes you can see in Sikkim and also West Bengal. So, what is the capital of West Bengal, children? It is Kolkata. But only north part of West Bengal is in this northern region. So orchards are grown here which are very beautiful. So what they grow, children? They grow orchards. People of Sikkim wear colorful clothes and jewelry made of gold and beads. So they wear colorful dresses and they also wear jewelry which is made up of gold and colorful beads. The famous hill station of Northwest Bengal is Darjeeling, which is famous for good quality of tea. So, West Bengal, only north part of West Bengal is included in the northern mountains, right? So, in that, what is famous, children? One hill station is famous. That hill station name is Darjeeling. We all know that Darjeeling is very famous for its tea powder. So, next. So, children, next we will learn about northeastern states. The states of Northeast India are together known as Seven Sisters. The largest state in the northeast is Arunachal Pradesh. So, children, northeastern Ghats. So, in the northeastern states, we call them as Seven Sisters. Already we have discussed about the Seven Sisters in our lesson number 1. Which states together called as Seven Sisters? Children, see here, I have written. Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland and Tripura. These seven states together, they are called as Seven Sisters. And where they are located? They are in the northeastern Ghats. So, the largest among these Seven Sisters is Arunachal Pradesh. Arunachal Pradesh is the largest. It is known as the land of rising sun. So in Arunachal Pradesh you can see the place where the sun rises first. So here you can see the sunrise. So it is called as the land of rising sun. The capital of Arunachal Pradesh. What is the capital of Arunachal Pradesh? It is Itanagar. Houses are built on stilts. They are built on stilts on the heights. Why they are built, children? Which protect them from rain and snakes. So, they jewels. The dance form Manipuri is very famous. It is having one main famous dance form, that is Manipuri, which is famous throughout our country. People here make beautiful things from, turn your pencil, bamboo, cane and leather. So people make beautiful items from which they make that beautiful items with the help of bamboo, cane and leather. Next, Meghalaya is the state which recently used the heaviest rainfall in India. So throughout the India, one of the seven sisters, that is Meghalaya, it receives a very huge rainfall. It is throughout the India, this is the state which receives a very heavy rainfall. Meghalaya means the abode of clouds. The capital of Meghalaya is Shillong. So what does Meghalaya mean, student? It is a means group of clouds. So the capital of Meghalaya is Shillong. The main tribes of this region, the tribe people which you can see in this are, they are Garo, Khasi and Jaintia. These are the three types of tribes which you can see in this Meghalaya state. The main occupation of people here is farming. What do people living in Meghalaya do, student? They do farming. Farming is the main occupation of the people who live in Meghalaya. The farmers here grow rice, potatoes, jute, sugarcane, oranges and pineapples. So what they grow, the farmers who cultivate in Meghalaya, what crops they grow, children? They grow rice, potatoes, jute, sugarcane, oranges and also pineapples. Next, Mizoram. Mizoram is a small state in the northeast. So out of seven sisters, Mizoram is the smallest state. The capital of Mizoram is Aizwal. What is the capital, student? It is Aizwal. The people of Mizoram are called Mizos. The people who live in Mizoram, what they are called? They are called as Mizos. Mizoram means the land of hilly people. So Mizoram meaning is the land of hilly people. The bamboo dance of Mizoram is very famous. So the people here, they do dance with the help of bamboo. That dance is very famous in Mizoram. Most of the Mizos are literates. Most of the people who live in Mizoram, they are literate, means they are educated. See here, you can see the traditional dress of Mizoram. Nagaland is a beautiful state of northeast. Next comes to Nagaland. It is the most beautiful state out of the seven sisters towards the northeast direction. The capital of Nagaland, what is the capital of Nagaland, children? It is Kohima. People of different tribes live here. So different tribal people live in Nagaland. Their tribe is identified by their design of the shawl they wear. So they wear shawl on their bodies. So different types of tribal people live. How can we identify with that tribe? To which tribe they belong? By the shawl they are wearing. By seeing the shawl which they wear, you know, the type of shawl. By seeing the type of shawl, we can identify to which tribe that people belong. Farming is the main occupation of the people. In Nagaland also, farming is the main occupation. The main crops grown are, what are the main crops grown here, see children? They are rice, maize, millets and oranges. These are the main crops which are grown in Nagaland. Nagaland is a land of songs and music. So it is famous for songs and music. It is also called as land of songs and music. Next, we will see, children. Here you can see the traditional dress of Nagaland people. Next, importance of Himalayas. We will learn about the importance of Himalayas. The Himalayas have always protected India from foreign invasions. They prevent the cold winds coming from the northern Asia from entering India. So Himalayas always protected our India. As we have already studied that Himalayas are on the border, on the north of our country, right? So they always protected us from foreign invasions. Not only that, they also Next, they prevent the rain bearing winds from leaving India. So they prevent rain winds to leave from India. Next, as a result, India gets heavy rainfall. Their time layers are stopping the rain, right? So that they can't go out of our India. So due to that, our India is also getting a very heavy rainfall. The glaciers of Himalayas provide water to the main rivers of India. The glaciers which are present in Himalaya, already we have discussed in that 3 ages, right? So the glaciers which are present in Himalayas, they provide water to many rivers. And they are the main rivers of India. The forests of Himalayas provide valuable products like timber, honey, resin and medicines. The forests which are present in Himalayas, no, they provide very valuable products to our country. What are the valuable products, children? They are timber, honey, resin and medicines. So these are the famous products which Himalayas provide to our country. So children, till now we have discussed about the importance of Himalayas, and also we have discussed about the lifestyle